I'm Phyllis Gumbel.
And I'm Keith Hampshire.
And this is SCTV Sports Central. Okay, let's not waste any time. There's probably nothing more exciting in sports. Nothing fires the imagination like a heavyweight championship fight. And boy, have we got a great one for you tonight. It's Gregorio Lopez, the current champ, unbeaten in 40 fights. Tonight looking stronger and better than ever. And his opponent, Hefty Neal. Well, Keith, what can you tell us about Neal?
Well, fellas, I think you have to go back to 1935. Let me set the scene for you. A muggy night in the Polo Grounds, a tremendous crowd screaming for blood. The heavyweight champ, Billy Dieselhead Collins, thought to be invincible, a hard man to hurt in the ring, going against a virtual unknown, total newcomer, Norman Rockwell. And what a battle it was. Dieselhead, of course, emerging eventually as the victor. It was a fight that ended Rockwell's boxing career. But, like a lot of boxers before him, he went on to become one of the great painters of his generation, joining the illustrious ranks of other boxer painters like welterweight Andrew Wyeth, featherweight Aubrey Beardsley, and then a heavyweight on any canvas, big man George Brock, who besides being a boxer
Keith,
and a painter...
Keith, this is all very interesting, but what's your point?
The point, fellas, is simply this. Neal must strike quickly tonight if he's going to take Lopez, because Lopez's combinations will take a devastating toll in the later rounds.
Yeah, those combinations can be deadly, huh, Keith?
Hey.
SCTV Sports has prepared a film on this challenger, Neal. Let's take a look at it.
See the fight? And what'd you think?
Well, I really didn't when I said it.
What?
Well, then I couldn't say it when it went too.
I can't understand you, can
Well, I really...
Huh? I really clobbered him, didn't I?
When you tried to do that, when it was really, I didn't respond.
I can't understand what you're saying.
Well, I didn't know it, then I couldn't say it.
What the hell are you saying?
Hey, kid. I was watching your fight out there, you know?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I like your style.
Hey.
You know what I think you need? I think you need a manager, you know?
I don't know.
Yeah, well, look, I used to be a pretty good fighter myself, you know?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, maybe you heard of me. My name is Rocky Balboa.
Balboa.
Italian Stallion. They made a movie about me, huh?
Oh, yeah,
yeah. Let me show you. It's a pretty good movie, too. Take a look at that, huh?
Hey, you got good style there, huh?
Yeah, good scenes and that.
Yeah.
Hey, now, look, I used to be a fighter just like you, you know?
Yeah?
Yeah, I was a bum, too.
Hey, I'm not no bum.
Hey, you're a bum.
I'm not a bum.
You're a bum.
Hey, look, I said I'm not a bum. You want to know why? Because I'm fighting the heavyweight championship of the world in 3 days. That's why I'm not a bum.
Heavyweight championship, huh?
That's right. Why don't you just get out of here, huh? Sure. Come on. Come on. Get out. I don't need no manager. Where were you when I needed you, huh? Go on. Get out of here. Call me a bum. You're the bum. Get out of here. I don't need anyone, you understand? I don't need anyone. Hey, your nerve coming in here calling me a bum. Manager. What do you think? You think I need a manager, huh?
Well, then I said I do.
Hey, you got a good point. Yeah, he wasn't such a bad guy, was he?
I don't know what's that.
Yeah, I know. Hey, Rocky! Rocky!
Hey, kid, hey. I knew you'd see things my way. Huh? There's a contract.
Hey, I'm real sorry, you know?
Hey, that's all right. Come on, we'll sign a contract.
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah, you're gonna like me. I'll be a good manager.
I'll be a good fighter for you, too.
You're gonna be a good fighter. I'll just sign this thing first, huh?
Okay, just sign up there.
Just put the old John Hancock.
All right.
Will you
cut that out?
Okay, I'll put my name down, all right? Okay, you sign too.
All right.
We'll start training, all right? Hey, you gotta get in shape. That fight's in 3 days.
That's right.
We'll start training tomorrow, okay?
Hey, thanks again. I'm sorry about all this.
All right, one thing. Remember, before the fight,
yeah?
No sex.
You got it, no sex.
Here.
Thanks again, huh? Hey, come on. What are you doing? Where are you going?
Oh, my brother.
Hey, you can stick around here for a while, huh?
Yeah, what?
Come on, honey. Listen, don't you like it here?
Yeah.
You know, you're kind of cute, yeah?
Yeah.
You really are.
Oh, my God.
Why don't you take your hat off?
No.
Yeah.
I got my brother.
You know, you're kind of cute without your glasses on. Hey, you know, say, what's that on your lip there?
We'll continue with SCTV's exciting film on this young challenger, Hefty Neal, right after these messages.
Hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you eating? Come on, let's go out there. Come on, turn this thing off.
Breakfast.
Let's go out there. Give me... Let's go. Come on. Yourself,
come on, let's go. I always train that way.
Yeah, well, you're still a bum. You know that?
Come on.
That's right. You're always gonna be a bum.
Hello, Hefty.
Hey. Come on. After the fight, huh? After the fight.
Oh, you sure have changed since I met you in the pet shop. Your hair doesn't smell like kitty litter anymore.
Oh, Hefty, everything's going to be different from now on. You've got a chance at the heavyweight title. Well, I'm beautiful and articulate all of a sudden. I've got everything I want.
I just want one thing. I just want to be on my feet at the end of the fight. I don't care if I win. I just want to show them I can take it. 15 rounds, go the distance with a champ. Then I'm going to know that all the bums and losers in this lousy, stinking world really have a chance to make it.
Okay, kid, come on, let's go.
Oh, Hefty, don't forget your trunks.
Great piece of film.
Hefty hopes he can go the distance, and frankly, so do I. I borrowed a lot of money from the bank and placed a big fat bet on him.
cleared 3 hours of airtime just for this fight, so we're going to bring you blow-by-blow action.
And a terrific wrap-up after the fight. I see they're introducing the fighters. And now let's go to ringside with SCTV's Lou Jaffe.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the main event of the evening, 15 rounds for the heavyweight championship of the world. In this corner, the challenger from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 318 pounds. In the spotted trunks, the Croatian Dalmatian, Hefty Near. And in this corner, the heavyweight champion of the world from Chihuahua, Mexico, weighing 210 pounds, Gregorio Lopez.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Lou Jaffe, and what an exciting boxing card we have lined up for you tonight. Gregorio Lopez defending his title against the young, aggressive Hefty Neal, a fighter, although relatively unknown, who could certainly go the distance. And this capacity crowd here tonight seems to know that. There is tension in the air as we wait for this much-publicized fight to begin. This reporter predicts it could be the fight of the century. And there's the bell to start round one. Both fighters leave their corners determined.
Fight is over. Well, that's going to give us a couple more hours wrap up on the fight than we were planning. About 2.5 hours to be exact. Phyllis, perhaps we should talk about it.
Well, Lou, I think it'd be interesting to see that lightning-fast punch in slow motion, possibly. How about it, Lou?
Phyllis, we do have a replay of that lightning-fast first round, and this is what it looked like not 2 minutes ago. There they are, both fighters leaving their corners, and Neal is down. That was the punch. I couldn't quite make it out. What can I say?
Lou, perhaps you could get a word with Lopez, the champion. I understand he has a really funny accent.
Lopez, Keith, is probably in his dressing room by now. He left the ring immediately after the punch was thrown.
Well, how about Hefty...
He's not here!
Well, how about Hefty Neal, Lou? Is he able to speak?
Hefty Phyllis is not here either. He was carried out to a waiting ambulance, and by the time I get down to the hospital, what with the Friday night traffic and so forth, I...
Lou, perhaps we could take another look at that replay.
Why?
I don't know. I'd just like to see it again.
Right you are, Keith. This is what it looked like, folks, not 3 minutes ago. There they are, the fighters in their corners. Both looking quite determined and sweating already, and Neal is down. That was the punch. It looked like an uppercut, a left hook, possibly a very strong jab. I didn't see the...
Well, tell me, Lou, do you think it looked like a premeditated fight plan that Lopez seemed to be following? Did it seem to be one that caught Neal and all of us completely by surprise?
I honestly couldn't tell you, Phyllis.
Lou, let me ask you this. I know that all of us here at Sports Central, certainly the fans, were hoping that this fight would last a lot longer than it did.
3 hours.
What we want to know here at Sports Central is, how do the fans feel? Are they disappointed?
Keith, there is absolutely no one left in the arena. I seem to be the only person here. Some started to file out as soon as Neal hit the canvas. My capsule comment?
Well, Hefty Neal certainly must be a disappointed young man, Lou. How do you think tonight's fight will affect his future? Lou?
Lou?
Lou!
That was Lou Jaffe at ringside. Well, it looks like we have some time on our hands here, Phyllis, and what an opportunity to take this time now to talk about some other big things.
Well, that was some fight, wasn't it, Keith? Well, that was exciting. Now let's quickly take a look around the world of sports. Nothing much going on there.
Well, Phyllis, I think at this point it might be interesting now to take a look at that lightning-fast, incredibly great first round, this time in slow motion backwards. We got that? Okay, now, the champ is down. The champ is down. We see Lopez dancing in his corner now, and He's twitching. The champ is twitching. He's up. He's bounding to his feet. Body check there from Lopez. His hands are up. It looks like he's calling for the ref. And he's in his corner now. Hands over his face. The bell sounds. That's the end of the fight.
That was exciting.
A short fight, but a great one. It takes me back now to another great fight, a long fight. John L. Sullivan versus Gentleman Jim Corbett. What a fight that was back in the 1890s. In the very beginnings of fights when people were using bare fists. It was just, they fought for the fun of it. 90, sometimes over 100 rounds, they'd be in there fighting and going nuts, and the fans would be going completely.
That's it from SCTV Sports Central. I'm Phil Stumble. Good night.